What's going on, guys? This is Pete, PeteIsip.com, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to hold it on this video today. I got a question in and a comment up that doesn't necessarily concern me, but I empathize with the comment and pretty much states that I'm trying so hard, I'm working out, I'm dieting, I'm doing what I want to do. But no matter what I do, in a nutshell, I can't grasp the fact of loving myself. I can't grasp the fact of that I'm not happy with who I am. I can't stop that defeating self-talk. And I completely understand where you're at. I completely get why you feel this way. But you have to realize right now that that's not your fault. That is not your fault. Okay, and it's easy for me to say so. It's easy for me to make this video and say it's going to be fine, but it's going to be a struggle, and I'm going to be honest with you. There used to be a time when I would wake up in the morning and do whatever I can, because I was just didn't want to wake up. You know, there are times in my life that I just was like, why do I even wake up? Why do I even have to look in the mirror? You know, there's times where you just don't want to fucking be alive. And, you know, body disorders, eating disorders, a bunch of that stuff, all those things kill 2 million people a year. You know what I mean? And it's all psychological. It's all in our head, guys. Like, people see change and people see you and they're happy for you and they see you getting better and they see you working. But at the same time, you're just not accepting the fact that you are beautiful. You're not accepting the fact that you're amazing. The biggest tip I could say for this is you have to forgive yourself. Because it's not what it is that's happening now. Okay? All this stuff, all those thoughts, all that you realize is something that happened in the past. Someone told you you were ugly. Someone told you you didn't look good. Someone told you every day to be better. Someone did it. Okay? It's not you. Someone in your life told you that you weren't good enough. But for you to reach out to me and to have the balls to just say something like that, you are good enough, and you are searching for something. You're searching for a better something. But like I tell everyone else, that if you don't find out where that's stemming from, you don't find out who or why that happened, and really digging deep, and sometimes digging deep is not a fun, that's not a fun dig. It's going to stir up a lot of emotions. It's going to stir up a lot of tears. It's going to stir up a lot of frustration. But you have to find out when that was and who that was or whatever it was. And you have to empathize. Don't feel sorry. I tell all business owners that they can't have a successful business. Anyone can't have a... You can't reach your goals. You can't reach any goals until you forgive yourself. Until you take whoever that little kid is, that something happened to you somewhere down the line. That little kid is a struggling kid. Like, I'll say it over and over again. Like, it's not my fault. If you want to, I'll relay it to me to take the pressure off you for a second, but I realized that it wasn't my fault. I was a kid that was 13 years old that friggin' watched a little kid, never went out, had tons of responsibility, had parents that wanted to become a doctor, an astronaut, or something. You had so much pressure growing up, and you're fucking 13 years old. All I want to do is not make a mistake. All I want to do is please everybody. All I want to do is just be fucking what my parents expected me to be, or what you always wanted someone else to expect you to be. And you're never good enough. You're never good enough. And that's not your fault. You know, how do you expect a fucking 13-year-old kid to have all those things? To develop to be this person and all that pressure and all the things going behind you? And you were fat and... People just fucking, people just suck sometimes. But you can't feel bad for that kid. You can't feel bad for that person that's sitting there, that's 13 years old, just trying to be good. You have to empathize with that kid. You have to find who that person was. That little version of you that was beat up, that was torn down, that was told they were ugly, that was told that they weren't good enough. And you have to give them a hug. You have to hug them. And don't feel bad. Because the reason they were in your life, that little 13 years, was to put you where you are today. And the reason you're reaching out is because you're trying to be better. That 13-year-old had no idea what he was doing. But he was leading my life. He was leading my life. And it wasn't until I saw my therapist. And that's what you have to do. You know, it took me years for me to realize that I needed therapy. To find out what it was. And she told me that he was driving the bus of my life. I need to say. That 13-year-old kid was driving my path. So I wasn't hitting my goals. I wasn't doing my things. I wasn't having any... I wasn't really loving myself either. Until I actually gave that kid a hug, and I told him to take a back seat. I told him he did a great job. That kid did the best job he could do for 13 years. He did whatever he could. He took a beating. Imagine taking a beating that hard and being that strong. I take him, and I'll put him into the back seat. And right now, the 36-year-old version of Pete is going to be driving the bus. I lead my path. My past is behind me. Okay, whatever I did, it's a clean slate. I don't feel bad for anything that I did. Guys, you don't understand how much shit I've done to myself, mutilation-wise, body image-wise, stuff like that. You have no idea. But I did it, and I accept it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here talking to you guys today. So like I said, the biggest steps I think for you to do is one, is to seek a therapist, because you're going to need that. Okay, you're going to need someone to talk to. You're going to need someone to find out what that underlying thing is. Number two, you are going to need to let go of that shit. All right, you have to find out whatever it is that's causing that question. For you, whatever it is for you to reach out to me, and there's something there, and you have to forgive it. You have to let that go. I don't want to add any more pressure into your life, but I would always say first is find someone to talk to find out where this all stemming from. What was that point in your life that it just went wrong? And that would just be step one, because it's going to be a lot of steps. I could probably talk forever about this. But right now, I hope that you know that you are a beautiful person inside. You are a beautiful person outside, and everyone sees it. But maybe you just don't see yourself. And if you're trying to fake self-talk, if you're trying to fake it, but you really don't believe it, you're just wasting your time. You have to find out where this is stemming from. And you have to find out more about the deeper inside, deeper you, deeper who you are. What stirs all this shit up? No, man, I'll probably talk about this again later on. But hopefully that sits in right now for a little bit. And I hope you have a good day. I really don't know how to sign off on this one. It's PeteIsip.com.